Hello, my aesthetically pleasing peeps. Today we are going on a very special walk, and that is a tour of the ugliest buildings in Edinburgh. About a week ago, I asked you over on Instagram about what your favorite, or more like least favorite, ugly buildings here in Edinburgh are, and I got so many great answers, and some of them were quite surprising to me. So I didn't build this list about just my opinion, I built it as a combination of what you told me you don't like and what I find interestingly ugly. So yes, let's go on a little walk and visit all of the architectural abominations and bleak brutalism of Edinburgh. Let's start with a bit of a surprise. Some of you mentioned to me that you find St Andrew's House to be an eyesore. This is the Scottish Government headquarters sitting under Calton Hill, and I guess I can imagine that it's just a bit too big, boxy and monolithic for some people. Personally, I enjoy its little Art Deco details, including the Art Deco lamps in front of it. It's been around since 1939, actually officially opened only one day after the war was declared. And number 9, probably not surprisingly, the Scottish Parliament. As I've only been in Edinburgh for the past 10 years, I never felt too attacked by the fact that this slightly mind-boggling structure pops up right in the UNESCO protected area of Edinburgh, but I can imagine how the taxpayers would be less than happy with the design. I think the most divisive part of the whole look are the mysterious shapes on the facade, which always looked like hairdryers to me. Please let me know in the comment section how you'd call them. What I found interesting is that Enric Miralles, the architect, used this element in some of his other buildings around the world too. At number 8, the Abbey Lane flats. Okay, so some of you might be less familiar with this beast than I am. It's because you didn't have to live right next to it for 5 years. Apparently it has been designed to reflect the shape of Salisbury Crags. I'm not sure if I see it. I would also guess that the color of the metal facade hasn't always been this Ponscum green color, but that's what it is now, and I don't think that it's going anywhere. At number 7, this is a twofer, it's Cameron Toll and what I like to call Edinburgh's Manhattan. This is a cluster of somewhat depressing architecture, which is thankfully situated quite far away from the city centre, so it's probably not gonna cause you any aesthetic shock if you're visiting. Cameron Toll was built in 1984, and it still carries a certain Stranger Thing-esque vibe, especially from the outside. The inside is kind of underwhelming, there's not really much going on architecturally. Clearly there has been some efforts to update it for a more modern look, and from what I've heard, they're trying to rebuild this whole area into something more modern and livable. A shortish walk from here is a quartet of late 60s apartment buildings, each offering 16 stories of flats, which is pretty high for Edinburgh. Visiting this neighborhood feels quite strange, as Edinburgh generally doesn't have that many high tower blocks, so walking through this area might give you a very unfamiliar perspective on the city. At number 6, St James Quarter. Of course, this list would not exist without the most divisive modern building of the last 2 years, more specifically the metallic cupola of the W Hotel. It seems to remind people of the shape of a well-formed dog poo. Personally, I don't quite agree with this, and honestly, after seeing dozens and dozens of bland student accommodations popping up, I am actually quite happy to see a little boldness, but I'm guessing this is a debate that will just go on and on until we get another weird expensive piece of architecture in the city centre to steal the spotlight. At number 5, George Square. I would say George Square is kind of like Edinburgh's Barbican. This area, mostly populated by Edinburgh University's buildings, brings a very eclectic vibe when it comes to architecture. Many of you have sent me messages about various buildings located here, including the Appleton Tower, a building so disliked that after wanting to make it an A-listed building, Edinburgh City Council had to deal with public uproar and take the proposition back. Then we also have the A-listed 40 George Square, formerly known as David Hume Tower, which I find delightfully depressing. The Lecture Theatre, which is probably the closest to like actual good old-fashioned brutalism here on George Square. And the main library, which is honestly quite delightful as a part of the square cityscape, but I wish it wasn't so hard to ignore looming over the meadows when viewed from the other side. We'll be right back. Intermission time! Did you know that Edinburgh could have been a lot more brutalist than it is? Post-war, a plan floated around for rebuilding the whole Princess Street in brutalist style, plus adding a motorway leading through the area. Now, just go back to the list and appreciate what we've got. At number 4, Lynxview House. Let's take a stroll to Leith now, a neighborhood that has more than 2 ugly buildings for sure, but only 2 of them are the true icons. The slightly lesser known is the Lynxview House. This slab block was built in the 60s to introduce better housing into the area and to fight slump problems. At number 3 we have the train-spotting famous banana flats. Just like Lynxview House, this long and somewhat funkily shaped brutalist block of flats has been given a listed status to make sure we don't tear it down and replace it with something more visually digestible, I guess. I'm sure we'll agree that buildings like this should not only be preserved to illustrate evolution of visual style, but also to remind us of the egalitarian philosophies behind brutalism. After all, both Banana Flats and Lynxview popped up here in Leith in effort to make sure everyone here gets a better place to live. And number 2, Jury's Inn. Before we learn what the truly most horrible eyesore in Edinburgh is, here's one that just feels absolutely visually frustrating to me. The Jury's Inn above the Old Town Arches. This bad boy is visible from so many photo spots, reliably ruining the old-timey vibe of all of your Instagram posts. This truly is possibly the only building on my list that I would have torn down in a blink. And at number 1, a big fanfare for the winner of this list, the Argyle House. I bet many of you have looked down upon Haymarket from the castle grounds and wondered, what in the heck is that atrocity and how will I Photoshop it out of my holiday pictures? The Argyle House is another piece of Scottish brutalism that has been successfully preserved for future generations, although it is not impossible that at some point in the future it will be replaced with something St. James Quarter-ish and people will have a brand new thing to complain about. Today it mostly houses private offices, also some Edinburgh University offices, and at its less visually offensive end you will also find Codebase, Scotland's largest tech incubator. So that was our list of 10 ugly buildings here in Edinburgh that I think you probably should see and maybe reconsider appreciating. I found doing this little tour by myself really interesting. I had a lot of fun researching what these buildings are about, what's in them or what used to be in them, and hopefully this video gave you some much needed enlightenment if you haven't been a fan of modern or ugly architecture until now. Obviously, as always, I would love to hear what you think, if you super disagree with me, if you think these buildings are beautiful, or if you think that they are so ugly that nobody should ever see them in any YouTube video ever, or if I missed any important icons of ugliness in this city. Yeah, I would love to have a little discussion with you down in the comments below. If you want to see what I'm up to in my everyday life, when I'm not too lazy to post, visit me on Instagram on khakibot and khakiblog for my illustrations and my photos and general life here in Edinburgh, which, you know, as you can see, is lately been quite windy, whimmed. You can also visit my Etsy store where I sell a lot of Scottish themed goods. This is kind of a low season, so please support me by buying a beautiful pin, like this one or this one. Yay. Okay. Thank you so much for joining me on this slightly alternative little tour of Edinburgh, and I shall see you soon. Bye bye. Uh oh.